Hey friends, hope you all are doing well. So I'm back with another GraphGAN pattern video. In this video, I'll show you how to create a GraphGAN pattern from a portrait. So let's go. So we'll start by making a bobbin. As I've shown in my earlier videos, it helps you to manage the different colored yarns during your crochet project. So I'd advise you to make 3-4 bobbins of each color at least before you start your project. You can use a cardboard or anything similar. I had this spare sponge, so I used this. You just have to cut out an hourglass shape and just cut out 2 slits so that you can enter the yarn there when not in use. Now we'll see how to create a GraphGAN pattern using the Wooltasia app. You can download the app for free in Play Store. So open the app and then click on New Project, Crocheting. Select your crocheting process. I have selected default, which goes row wise. Now select the picture from the gallery. I've selected a picture of my own because I won't disappoint anyone else if it doesn't go well. You know what I mean? Because this is my first attempt at this. So anyway, check the dimensions of the picture. And see, I have already explained this process in detail in a previous video of mine. You can check out the card above, or I'll also give the link in the description. So you can see it there. So I wanted this project to be as simple as possible, so I selected only 4 colors, red, orange, white and black, and I have reduced the pixels to 58 by 58. The higher the number of pixels, the detailed your pattern will be, but I wanted to make it small. So that was the smallest I could get to, you know, without making it look weird. Also, I've selected the colors red, orange and white here, but actually I have used red, orange and yellow for the skin and white only for the eyes. So you can give a name to your project. Here are all the details about the project, its dimension and colors and all. And you can also see the time you spent and the time left for the project. So just select the handedness, right-handed or left-handed, and then click on Begin. Now, I was so excited to start it that I forgot to shoot the beginning. Anyway, I just made a chain of 59 because I have 58 stitches in each row. So I made the first line with the blue color. As you can see, it can also act as a border kind of thing. So here you can see I have completed 2 or 3 rows already. You can also notice that there are so many bobbins already in use. Here I have shown a few stitches of the second row. As you can see from the inset, each stitch is represented as a small box. So it makes it easier to follow the pattern. 2 things you have to definitely keep in mind, that in this default process, each row starts from the opposite side, and also you have to make a chain at the end of each row so that it's easier to start the next line. It acts as a connection between the 2 rows. Another important thing while creating a GraphGAN pattern is you have to carry the yarn forward from previous line, or you can have to carry it forward for the next line and so on. This helps the pattern look the same from the front and the back, and there are no loose yarns hanging out. Again, I have shown all this in detail in my previous GraphGAN pattern video, so don't forget to check it out. And while you're at it, please, please, please subscribe to my channel. So enjoy the rest of the video and take care of you and your family. Bye-bye.